Benedict's portrait was mounted at the entrance of Rubaga Cathedral, guarded by papal soldiers. At 2 p.m., the portrait was removed from the entrance and taken inside the cathedral, welcomed by the Pope's envoy, Luigi Bianco, and the bishops. Later, the Pope's envoy, assisted by the Archbishop Paul Semogerere and other priests, led a mass which was attended by various officials, including Buganda Kingdom Prime Minister Charles Peter Maiga, Italian Ambassador to Uganda Massimiliano Manzanti, opposition leader Matthias Mpuga, and other dignitaries. In his first message, Luigi Bianco read the history of Pope Benedict and hailed him as a peaceful leader. He said the former Pope was an example for the Church, especially in his messages of hope and strengthening of faith.
So he did a very large service to the Gospel and to the Church during more than 70 years as a priest, bishop, and as a Pope and shepherd of the Universal Church. During 7 years, 10 months, and 9 days, until the 28th of February.
Bianco urged believers to have love for one another in order to strengthen their faith.
The living one and the Lord was the destination to which Pope Benedict led us, taking us by the hand. May he help us rediscover in Christ the joy of living and the hope of living.
We can rightly acclaim that he was a prophet of our time and truly enlightening society. Then again, we have got to contend that his deep insight and knowledge was not just because of his intellectual smartness. He was also a deeply prayerful man. This life of prayer for Pope Benedict was founded on his contemplation of the scriptures and the teaching of the fathers of the Church, which was also his method of doing theology.
The Archbishop of Mitiana Diocese, Anthony Ziwa, presented a message of condolence from all bishops. He praised Benedict for his unforgettable legacy.
On behalf of the Catholic bishops of Uganda, and on my own behalf, on behalf of the clergy, religious, and the laity of Uganda, I would like to convey our heartfelt condolences and sympathy to His Holiness Pope Francis, and to you, his representative, the Apostolic Nuncio to Uganda, Archbishop Luigi Bianco. Upon the death of Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI, Pope Benedict, like St. Paul, has fought the good fight to the end. He has run the race to finish.
The Katikkiro of Buganda, Charles Peter Maiga, extended his condolence message to the Church.
And before his elevation to the head of the papacy, he was instrumental in defining the position of the Church on spiritual matters concerning Catholics and the entire global Christian community.
Pope Benedict was today buried under St. Peter's Basilica in the tomb last occupied by Pope John Paul II.
Die Spiritus Sancti.
Amen.
Pax vobis.
Et cum spiritu tuo.